The rules against blocking and discrimination would be incomplete if we didn't have exceptions. There are a couple of exceptions, but the one I want to talk about here is the exception for reasonable network management. So when I go into this, I want to state very clearly, the question is not, should we allow internet service providers to manage their networks? Of course we should. You know, it's in our interest that they can manage their networks, that if there is congestion, they can deal with it, so that we all have a good quality experience online. So the real debate is not in the if, the real debate is how should we allow them to manage their networks? Now you might say, you know, why should we worry? If I think back to your example of Skype, clearly that's a real problem, that's anti-competitive, or even your telecommunications workers union example. But if a network provider just interferes with applications to manage the network, that's pretty innocent. You know, shouldn't we just say, blocking and discrimination is okay whenever a network provider manages the network? Now that you have a moment to think about that, the answer is no. And there are a couple of reasons for that. First, you might think, oh, who cares about congestion? You know, that's really technical. But the reality is, what network providers do during times of congestion will actually affect how most of us experience the internet. Congestion means everybody wants to use the network at the same time and there is not enough capacity available for everybody. When does that happen? It's a little bit different, but approximately from 5 p.m. to midnight. So when all of us come home after work or when we come back from school and we all go online, that's when internet service provider manage congestion. And so what they are allowed to do during times of congestion will affect how we experience the internet when we go online in the evening. So the second aspect is, we talked about the motivation, but does it really matter? So in the UK, we have this example where the British ISP, British Telecom, decided that if you bought their up to 8 megabits per second broadband internet service packets, you would only be allowed to use up to 768 kilobits per second of streaming video from 5 p.m. to midnight. So if you live in a house with other people, that meant only one of you could watch the video and only at relatively low quality. So what's the problem? Well, it's pretty clear. If my son comes home and wants to do or needs to watch a video of Martin Luther King's speech online for his social studies homework, we don't care if he can't access the video because the internet service provider views YouTube as a competitive threat, or whether the internet service provider blocks Martin Luther King because he is racist and doesn't like people to watch that speech, or whether you can't watch the speech because it's network management. So from the perspective of the user, what's relevant is the effect, not the motivation. And from the perspective of the application provider, it's the same thing. Again, I don't care why I can't access my users. My investors don't care. It's that I can't get to them. That's important. So looking at network management is just as important as looking at what network providers do for other reasons. So now you might say, well, and maybe there is no other way. Maybe we need to deal with congestion by allowing internet service providers to single out those applications that create a lot of bandwidth, or those classes of applications. So fortunately, sort of, we have tested this for you in the US. So when Comcast interfered with BitTorrent in 2007 and people complained to the Federal Communications Commission, Comcast said, but we have to do this. There is no other way to manage congestion. The FCC looked at this and talked with many network engineers, and it said, you know, we think there is another way. And this way looks as follows. So if there is congestion, then ISPs need to be allowed to divide or allocate bandwidth among users. They need to be able to limit how much data we can send into the network. It's like trying to deal with congestion on the highway, like preventing additional cars from coming onto the highway. We all agree that is important, and that that is something the network providers should be allowed to do. But when they make the decision about who gets how much bandwidth, they cannot tie that to the applications or classes of applications that users are using. So they cannot say, oh, we limit the amount of bandwidth available to online video, or we throttle the amount of bandwidth to peer-to-peer file sharing applications. What can they say? They can use criteria that have nothing to do with the applications that users are using. So they might say, you know, you have used the internet nonstop for the past 24 hours and I'm just coming online. So I get disproportionately more traffic during times of congestion than the person who has surfed nonstop to create some fairness over time. There are lots of other examples. The key thing that unites all of them is that during times of congestion, even though bandwidth is limited, we, the users, are still the ones who get to decide how we want to use it. And the application providers can still get to users within the limited amount of bandwidth that's available to them. In 2008, the Federal Communications Commission required all fixed network providers in the US, so those that provide internet services over wires, cable, telephony wires, to manage their network in this way. We call this network management needs to be targeted and tailored only during times of congestion, and it needs to be as application agnostic as possible. The as possible is important because clearly there might be problems that cannot be dealt with in an application agnostic way. Imagine there is this application that's engaged in a denial of service attack on your network. Then the ISP doesn't have to say, oh, I'll just block everything indiscriminately. Of course they can target that application and deal with that. So the as possible gives you a safety valve to deal with those situations that cannot be, where it's just impossible to remain neutral. This kind of rule has been used in the US and Canada since the late 2000s. And so all United States and Canadian fixed internet service providers manage their networks this way. So this is not sort of a nice idea by academics. This has been tested in the real world. At the same time, we know that if you look to other countries that have not imposed the same kinds of requirements, internet service providers primarily manage congestions by singling out selected applications or classes of applications and limiting the amount of bandwidth available to them. So that means if you have great rules against blocking and discrimination, but a bad network management exception, you have just sold out all the level of protection that you thought you got. So even though it's very technical, it's very important to pay attention to.